Good afternoon and welcome to America's Home Cooking. Today I'm going to be doing some canning. I'm going to can papaya and I'm also doing spicy pickled beets, which my family loves. I have 4 pounds of beets. I've already boiled these and peeled them, so they are ready to be chopped up. But we're going to get the liquid going. So let me see. We're going to need... Or with boiling water and cook till tender. Yeah, because you have to cook these till they're tender so you can drain and remove the peelings and trim the ends. Now we're going to add 2 cups of sugar in here into this pot. With that, we are going to add 3 sticks of cinnamon. We need a tablespoon of mustard. I need my measuring spoon. Tablespoon of mustard seed. And we need a teaspoon of whole cloves. And we need a teaspoon of allspice. We need a teaspoon of salt. Please make sure that you're using canning and pickling salt. The other ones change the color of the food and taste and all. Going to make, they say, 4 quarts or 8 pints. I'm making 8 pints. All right. I need another measuring cup. We need 2.5 cups of cider vinegar. Have my jars and the water here. I'm heating my water up and I've already done the lids and the rims. They're all washed and cleaned. And you need 1.5 cups of water. And we're going to have to add 3 cups of onions. And they want the onions thin sliced. So I need a 9. They say it'll take about 3 onions, but I don't know what size onions they're using, so I just figured out. It's going to take 3 onions. 1 onion makes a cup. You're going to need 3 onions. Another onion. going to bring this to the boil. While this is boiling, we're going to cut our beets up. How long do we want this to boil? It says bring to a boil, then we're going to reduce the heat and simmer for 5 minutes. While that's going on, I'm going to start cutting my beets up. Okay, we have to wait now.
Okay. The vinegar and water and spices are boiling. Turn it down and you're going to simmer it for 5 minutes.
And then I'll be back in 5 minutes.
If you, the 4 pounds of beets, they want 1 to 1.5 inch diameter, but I just buy the loose big ones and cut them down in size. They say it's going to make 4 pints, but believe you me, it's going to make a lot more.
Okay, it's been 5 minutes. Now what you're going to do is we're going to add the beets to this, and we're going to heat them through, and then we're going to can them.
Now we have to wait again.
Okay, the beets are heated through, so I'm going to go ahead and get the jars out and we'll start canning. Canning has come such a long way from the way my grandmother did it. She used to put her canned goods in the barn. You take the side door and look right, and you see her shelves and all her canned goods right there. And if you walked further in and went left, she had a frame to make quilts, because that's what she loved to do, to make quilts. And she did all that quilt work by hand. We have sewing machines and stuff, and she just had a little container. I want to call it a sewing box, I guess is what you'd call it, and she used that. And everything was there that she needed. Say we've come a long way in a lot of things when you think about what women had to do at one time. It was a lot of handwork all the time.
Well, here it is.
I can't remember how much this makes. That's why I did so many jars.
Well, if I don't have enough to fill these jars, I will have to make more. Two jars I have to make another batch for. Debubbled. If I can't do that one, I'm going to have to boil some water and put on these because it's dropping down. This happens sometimes. So, get my recipe and start again. Ooh. So let me get some more of this going and then we'll finish. Okay, I made extra and divided it up among all of them. And now I'm going to seal them. I'm going to clean the room. I'm going to have to mark that down. It does not make 4 pints. And don't worry, the jars are still very hot. That's why I move very quickly to make extra. I have to. So actually, when I make this, I'm going to mark it that I have to 1.5 ingredients for 4 pounds of beets, because I don't use the baby beets. If you use the small, really small ones, if you could find them, I never find them, so I use the big ones and cut them down. Make sure you 1.5 it if you're using 4 pounds. Make sure your jars are covered. They have, even the top has to be covered. They always recommend 1 or 2. Mostly they prefer 2 inches above the jars. Now we're going to bring that to a very hard boil. And I will be back when that happens. Okay, we're now going to time them because I've got a royal boil there. For 30 minutes. Okay, it's been 30 minutes. I marked in my cookbook, if you're using small beets, 1 to 1.5 inch diameter, the recipe would be to 4 pounds of those kinds of beet, 3 cups of thinly sliced onions, 2 cups of sugar, 3 cinnamon sticks, a tablespoon of mustard seed, a teaspoon of whole allspice, a teaspoon of whole clove, a teaspoon of salt, 2.5 cups of cider vinegar, and 1.5 cups of water. Now, if you do like I do, just buy the beets, whatever size they are, and you cut them down, for 4 pounds of regular beets like that, you would need 4.5 cups of thinly sliced onions. You would need 3 cups of sugar, 4.5 sticks of cinnamon, 1.5 tablespoons of mustard seed, 1.5 teaspoons of whole allspice, 1.5 teaspoons of whole clove, 1.5 teaspoons of salt. Wait, am I gonna figure this one out? 3 3/4 cup apple cider vinegar, and wait a minute, that's 2 1/4 cups water. Okay, I just wrote it down in my recipe so I won't have to make a mistake and have to make a second batch and rush the way I did. Anyway, these are very good, very, very good. That's how you do it. Take care. Bye-bye.